recorded or unrecorded, or a little bit of each. No matter who you are or where you're on life's journey, you are welcome here. So as we gather together, let's take a moment to breathe. Breathe in the spirit who dwells among us. Breathe in life. Breathe out death. Breathe in spirit. Breathe out numbness. Breathe in awareness. Breathe out neglect. Breathe in connection. Breathe out detachment.
Good morning. Please join in the call to worship in their bulletin. This is the day that God has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
God finds the useful in the outcasts and the fruitful in those who are shunned.
Give thanks to God, for God is good.
God's mercy will endure forever.
O God, hear us when we cry out in our loneliness and frustration.
Be with us in our lonesome nights, as well as our joyful days.
Be with us now in whatever place we find ourselves.
You've got to walk that lonesome valley. You've got to walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here gonna walk it for you. You've got to walk it by yourself. Well, some say John, he was a Baptist. And some say John, he was a Jew. I say John, like the Holy Bible, which says that John was a preacher too. And there's a road that leads to glory through a valley far, far away, and nobody else can walk it for you. No, they can only point the way. You've got to walk that lonesome valley. You got to walk it by yourself. Ain't nobody here gonna walk it for you. You've got to walk that lonesome valley for yourself.
Please join me in an invocation. God of life's rhythms, remind us when we feel that the night may never end, that dawn is on the way, when all we can hear are lonesome whippoorwills and the whistles of the midnight trains. Help us to listen for the song of the sparrow and the squeal of laughter. Continue to remind us of the surprise of resurrection. And be with us now as we celebrate life's unbroken triumph over death. Amen. We're going to sing.
What wondrous love is.
Let us prepare ourselves to hear the word of God by being in an attitude of prayer. Holy God, source of all light, by your word you give light to the soul. Pour out upon us the spirit of wisdom and understanding, that, being taught by you in Holy Scripture, our hearts and minds may be opened to know the things that lead to life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Hank Williams Sr.'s rendition of I'm So Lonesome I Could Cry ends with the lines, "The silence of a falling star lights up a purple sky. And I wonder where you are. I'm so lonesome I could cry." As Mary made her way to the tomb that early Sunday morning, she may have seen a shooting star while she was overcome with the grief of Jesus's harsh and sudden death. Adding insult to injury, she now has found the tomb empty and is at her wit's end, breaking down in tears, but her weeping will not last long. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting there, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? For whom are you looking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go on to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. May God bless to our understanding this reading from the Holy Word.
Will you pray with me? Come and fill our hearts with your peace. You alone, O Lord, are holy. Come and fill our hearts with your peace. Alleluia. In a clergy group meeting about a year ago, we were talking about how small things were really starting to set us off. And someone mentioned that all the stress of the pandemic life already took up 80% of our emotional bandwidth. So just waking up in the morning, not even thinking about anything, the stress of the pandemic already had us at 80% of what we can handle. So then when something else would happen, like something that was disappointing or frustrating or annoying, it would put us over the edge because we didn't have any more bandwidth left. But this person pointed out, we should still make room to feel the feelings. And in our scripture today, Mary is in a similar place. Her emotional bandwidth has already been depleted by watching Jesus' crucifixion and death. And now she's gone to the tomb, still while it was dark, and on her own. And she found the stone rolled away. And that puts her over the edge. She didn't even look in, but she ran to get some disciples because she assumed the body had been stolen. Because why else would the stone have been moved? The men run and find only the linens, no body, nothing else. So now Mary, who's a hot mess, gets back to the tomb and then decides to look in, seeing two angels who ask her, why is she crying? And she's desperate at this point. She practically blows them off. And when And then when someone else asks, why is she crying? She's at her wit's end. She just wants to know where Jesus' body is. And then Jesus says her name. And she actually sees him. And she's no longer crying. And she is still feeling her feelings. Hank Williams recorded the song, I'm So Lonesome I Could Cry, in 1949 at the height of his fame and only 3 years before his tragic death at the age of 29. Elvis Presley called this song the saddest song he ever heard. And the song gives a glimpse into Williams' struggles with physical suffering and feeling adrift. There's only 4 verses to this song. It only has 16 lines, and it describes a deep loneliness and a universal pain. But it also describes a man who's not quite in touch with his feelings. He's so lonesome he could cry, but he doesn't. The last verse of that song that Dimitri read earlier describes what Mary must have been feeling as she walked to the tomb that morning, grieving her friend, trying to process the events of the last days. The silence of a falling star lights up a purple sky. And as I wonder where you are, I'm so lonesome, I could cry. Elvis called this the saddest song ever because it names a state we've all been in, where we've lost someone dear to us for whatever reason, and everything we see and hear, birdsong, train whistles, fading moonlight, we've all been there when everything we experience is an embodiment of our sadness. We may even project our despair onto a migratory bird, thinking that it is losing the will to live when it's only just time to fly south. There has been much to mourn in these 18 months. Lost loved ones, lost livelihoods, lost routines, lost favorite businesses, and that sense of potential loss is looming large again as the Delta variant continues to rage on. Hank Williams' song may speak to us in our bones the way the pandemic life has caused lonesomeness on some levels. We may feel like Mary wandering around in the dark, full of grief or anger or sadness. The threat of another winter of pandemic life may have us reeling, wondering what happened to life as we knew it 2 years ago, and will it ever come back? The interesting thing between Mary and Hank Williams is Mary is unafraid to feel her feelings and express them. Mary unashamedly weeps through most of this passage. She's weeping outside the tomb. She's weeping looking inside the tomb. The angel asks her, why are you weeping? And Jesus asks you, why are you weeping? She is having her feelings and she does not care who knows it. Hank, on the other hand, is also in a lot of pain, physical and emotional. He's in the song, he's suffering a loss of someone, we don't know who. But he's so lonesome he could cry, but apparently he doesn't. We are in another painful place with infections up and school starting and parents terrified for their young children's safety, and we might not know what to do with those feelings. Don't listen to Hank. Listen to Mary. Feel the feelings, cry the tears, weep, yell at God. God can handle all of it. The pain, the anger, the frustration, the fear, all of it. God can take our feelings and God will give us someone to help us through them. When Mary's in the deepest part of her feelings, that's when she looks into the tomb and that's when she sees the angels. And that is when she sees Jesus. Jesus is there when she's at her lowest point. There's a lot of fatigue after all this time with pandemic life. And with that fatigue comes strong feelings right under the surface. Feel the feelings. We're all crossing this valley in different ways. And like the song earlier said, we can only cross this valley by ourselves. But we can find folks to help us get there together if we look for them to help us. And who shows up may be a total surprise to us, like Jesus surprised Mary, or they could be some of our oldest or dearest friends. But when we are in those depths, if we go looking for someone to help us, they will show up, just like Jesus did. Now, as we potentially face another winter, hunkered down, avoiding each other in order to keep us all safe, feel the feelings, vent the feelings, God can handle them, and God will help us find others to help us handle them as well. Amen. One of the ways that we do come together is through when we share our joys and concerns, we can help us on that valley, on that lonesome valley. And so now is the time that we share our joys and concerns with one another. If you are online and you have some joys or concerns to share, please type those in the chat box and we will read those out loud. Is there anybody in the space who has joys and concerns they want to share? Prayers for the family of Don Rowland, R-O-W-A-N, who passed away recently. He's a longtime teacher in the community. So we pray for his family, God, in your mercy. Okay. We do want to continue to keep the Brady family in our prayers, supporting Karen at the loss of her father. So we hold them close. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We also hold our friend and member Steve Watson in continued prayers as he remains in the hospital. So God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. I also want to hold a friend from Chicago whose father entered hospice this week. And so it just feels like there's a lot of folks in that space right now losing fathers for some reason. And so we hold my friend Carrie and all those who are mourning losses. God in your mercy. Jesse, who's in the chat box?
From Terry. Prayers also for Don Crumrine, who has been hospitalized for many weeks.
God in your mercy.
From Annie, prayers for Garrison, who is having bypass surgery tomorrow.
God in your mercy.
From Karen, prayers for all those who lack shelter and safety in the face of storms of all sorts. May they find whatever they need and community to help lift them up.
God in your mercy. Was that it?
Yep.
So your brother-in-law that's in hospital? So Dave's brother-in-law, Dave, is entering hospice, and so we hold him and Dave's sister, in-law, in prayer at this time. God in your mercy. We also want to continue to hold the people in Afghanistan in our prayers as they continue to deal with all the chaos in that place. God in your mercy. Any latecomers in the chat? Then let us be in a spirit of silent prayer. And for those of you online, if you want to rest it, because we can all hear you, when we get to the Lord's Prayer, you can unmute. So let us be in a spirit of silent prayer. O Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord, hear our prayer. When I call Holy, gracious, and loving God, we are so grateful for this day, and we ask your continued blessings on all of us. Hold all of us close who are mourning losses, facing losses, for all of us who feel lonesome, and help us to feel our feelings, help us to cry the tears, help us to find those who can walk this road together. We ask all these things, whether out loud or in the silence of our hearts, in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen, amen. Please remute, and let us be in a spirit of song with our next hymn. Have a few announcements this morning. We're winding up our school supply drive, so if you have not yet had a chance to make a donation for that, if you're in the space, we have our little happy mailbox back there if you want to put in a check or a few dollars, or you can do this online as well. We're hoping to take the cash for that and buy supplies and drop those off at the town hall with the social worker so she can get that to students in the area in need. Our goal was $1,500. I know we were at about $300 early this week. I have no idea what it is now, but I'm pretty sure it will grow. So, you know, got to start somewhere. And this is an exciting time for us to be able to help our local students. In 2 weeks, we have our combined service with Salem Church and New Preston Congregational Church down at the Pavilion. So that'll be on September 5th, Labor Day weekend. And for us here, reminder, it starts at 10:30, not at 10, although if you're early, it's always better than being late. And bring something that represents the tools that you use in your life, whatever it means to you. Oh, because we bless them during this service. And also continue to drop off non-perishable food items. And at the parish house, we do still continue to collect food for our food insecure folks as well. Our steeple lighting this week are from two different folks. One is in memory of Bertram Buddy Kay, and those were given by Art and Liz Peterson. And the other is in loving memory of Jared Sinistad, given by Betty, Eric, and Jed Sinistad. And we are so grateful for those donations as well. No flowers today. And so this is the time that we normally need to come together to gather our gifts. We do have the boxes in the back for those who are here. We just need as a reminder, I mean, it's pouring down rain. Jesse is in Wallingford. We're here. Folks are online. And we can still have church together, even if it is a little awkward and unsettling. But we're still here having church, worshiping God. We can do that thanks to you. And so we are just so blessed. For all your generosity, we ask that you continue to do that. And so you can do that through the website, through the Banco mobile app, online bill pay, mail a check, or again, the box in the back. But however you do it, we are so grateful that you do. And so thank you.
Hear that lonely whippoorwill, he sounds too blue to fly. The midnight train is whining low. I'm so lonesome I could cry. I've never seen a night so long. When time goes crawling by, the moon just went behind the clouds to hide its face and cry.
So friends, let us leave here with open hearts to share God's unconditional love with all we need. We will go with courage. holding fast to what is good, rendering to no one evil for evil. We will strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, and help the afflicted. Honoring all beings, we will serve God, rejoices in the power of the Holy Spirit. So friends, hear these words of benediction as we leave this place. Let us remember that our feelings are valid, all of them. They are gifts from God to remind us that we are alive. And so let us go in peace knowing God can handle everything we throw back to God. Amen. All y'all online want to stay a minute for a coffee hour, feel free. But stay safe with all this rain, regardless.